freeing is it now that you guys don't have the Tez Walker situation over your head thinking about it every week?
It's definitely freeing. You know, I think everybody's just happy that he gets to play, not only because he helps our team, but just as a brother and as a friend, I know it's kind of eating him up not being able to play. So I'm just really happy to have him back, happy that he got his feet wet a little bit today. So just real good to have him back.
Were you almost like nervous, like watching kind of like a parent whenever he was out there, like, you know, catching passes? Was just like so amped up for him, so excited for him, just based on what he's been through?
No, I wouldn't say I was nervous. Just excited. I mean, I know what he can do. I know what his ability is. So I was really just waiting on him to make plays, and he was able to make a few plays for us tonight. So just very proud that he was out there, did what he did.
I asked you Tuesday, scale 1 to 10. Teams report says 7.5 or an 8, and I asked what would it take to get to a 10. Was this a 9, 4.5, or 4.7 trajectory upward?
Yeah, this was definitely a 9-10 type of game. Played great ball on defense, only gave up one touchdown, held them to only about around 200 yards total offense. Our offense played great, 400-something yards passing, 200-something yards rushing. So we just played a very complete game all around, offense and defense. I'm just proud of the way we played.
To see the game plan with Garrett Schrader come to life and have you guys execute with all the gaps and not letting him get around the edge, that has to be unbelievably satisfying for you, given the track that you guys have been through.
Yeah. I think one thing that we made very important is that we got to contain this dude. Talking to Coach Chiz before the game, he was talking to us and he was saying, we can't come back in here after the game and say we didn't stop him, and we knew we had to stop him. So I'm glad that we went out there, executed, and was able to contain him.
He's pretty fired up, second half.
Yeah, he was pretty fired up, yeah.
Well, he always seems like he's sort of steady.
No, he can get a little bit intense at times, definitely.
Seemed like after Amari got that interception, you, Power, Dez, Sticks, some of the older guys are kind of there crowding around. Just take me through that moment and kind of what that shows of this defense, just the connectedness with the younger guys and everywhere at the positions.
Yeah, I think, you know, you hit it spot on. I mean, just seeing a younger guy make a play, a guy in my room, the linebacker room, I mean, I was excited as all get out. I was happy for him. He's a great player, a great young man. Came in here early, and we seen his progression from the spring until now. We knew that he was going to be a pretty good player. Was able to play a little bit some today. And he made a play, so I was just very excited, you know, for him.
In terms of from start to finish, was this the most complete defensive outing you've been a part of since you've gotten here? And is that almost like a culmination of everything that you've been through and this defense has been through, you know, from last year moving in through this season?
Yeah, this is definitely the most complete game we played as a defense, at least that I've been a part of. Like I said, holding a team to 7 points, I can't remember when's the last time we did that. So yeah, it was just a very, very complete performance for the defense, and I'm very proud of how we played.
How cool. What did you make of the play of the younger guys late in that game? Obviously, Campbell and Cheeks were out there, but some other guys, you know, into the depth chart. What did you think of the way the rest of the defensive depth played for them?
Yeah, I was proud of them. I mean, like I said, I'm always happy when the younger guys, guys lower on the depth chart, kind of get a chance to play. You know, those guys come in and work hard just like, you know, the starters do. So it's just very exciting to see them go out there and make plays.
Y'all had some pretty good defensive performances this year, South Carolina, and now this game. I mean, after some of the scores like last year, like App State, you gave up 61 points. How does it feel to look up and see that you gave up 7 points, which is the first time y'all won that since 2021?
Yeah, I mean, it's very exciting. I mean, it's something that this defense, we knew we had to do. We knew we had to make a change. We knew we had to be better this year. And to see it kind of playing out and us really executing it, I mean, I'm just proud of the team, proud of how the defense is playing, and just want to keep this going for the rest of the year.
How cool is it?
One of the cool things, I mean, 5-0 is great, but it's one of the cool things from a team-wide perspective. It really does seem like you guys are getting better as you go here. Like, you know, you're continuing to make progress. Is that, like, have you noticed that?
Yeah. I mean, I definitely feel like we're getting better every game we play as a defense. You know, even though we shut out South Carolina or had a great defensive performance, we still made a lot of mistakes that game. And just to see, you know, how we've progressively gone up until this game where there were very few mistakes defensively. And so I just see us getting a lot better. talk about that 5-0 thing. Coach Chia said something funny. He said, think about the last time you've been 5-0. And I couldn't speak for other guys, but for me, it had to have been Little League. It, like, it was a long, long time, so it feels really good to be 5-0.
What was that Little League team, man? We'll put it in there. We got Carolina Stars in there this week.
Valentine Gators.
All right.
Yeah.
You know, another thing, in 4 second half against Power 5 teams, you guys have been 13 points offensively. Because you guys were pretty good on the last week.
We'll say that.
I don't know, man. Sorry, remember it. Corrected me, Jeremiah. Jeremiah's smiling, man. What does it say about you guys? The adjustment. We've talked a lot about adjustments in the show, but you guys continue to kind of reach the bar on that.
Yeah, I think we just continue to grow in that area. Like I said 2 weeks ago, you know, we come out of halftime, you know, we're always making adjustments to what we're doing. It doesn't matter if we're blowing them out or not. You know, there's still some things that, you know, we can fix and we can execute better. So that's what we're continuing to doing and continue to play better in second halves is something that we've made very important for our defense is to not give up points in the second half. So proud of the way that we played.
Sid, how cool is it to see KBJ out there making plays on the D-line? He had kind of a tough start to his college career, but now he's, you know, finally in a place where he's able to get out on the field. I mean, how cool is that?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, that's a guy who kind of came in here, you know, he was hurt, you know, the first few years, and just kind of seeing him battle and work to get back to where he is now to be able to get on the field. I mean, it's awesome. Like I said, you know, having him as a brother and seeing him from a friendship standpoint, being able to get back on that field, I mean, it's amazing, and I'm just happy for him.
How much more confidence do you think this unit collectively is playing with compared to last year, you know, with the production and the results you guys have seen so far?
I think we're a lot more confident. I think I said that 2 weeks ago, too, as well. Like, our confidence, you know, it doesn't waver. Even when teams make plays or whatever happens, we just believe that we're that good and we're going to make plays in the game to impact the game and change the game. So I think our confidence is sky high right now.
What about maturity in terms of where you guys were a couple years ago? You'd be concerned after buys or after you guys had big wins and with success. Is this a more mature group?
Yeah, I definitely think this is a more mature group for a couple of reasons. I think, you know, we got some older guys on the team who got have been through a lot and seen a lot. But not only that, I think we've been through, you know, a lot. You know, thinking back to the 2021 season, just a terrible year for us. And then last year, kind of playing well, and then dipping off at the end. You kind of learn from those mistakes and mature and grow in those things. So I think we're able to do that, and we're just going to continue to go up this year.
On that note, you started 2021, you ranked 10th in the country. You got to get close to that ranking again. Got the ranked matchup next week. How much better equipped do you think this group is to handle everything that comes along with that?
Yeah, I think this team is a lot better equipped. Like I said, this team is more mature, more confident, and just better all around as a team. And so I think, you know, understanding what's at stake and not letting anybody get complacent or anything like that, I think we'll be just fine.
I like the chain. Why'd you choose a lightning bolt chain?
No reason. I just thought it looked cool.
What was your perspective on Kobe Pacer's touchdown and double tapping with his left hand? Drake said he's left-handed, but what was your perspective on how he was able to recover that ball?
I mean, it was just a great catch. I told him that might be on top 10 tonight. I mean, just great catch, great play, and just proud of him.
All right. Thanks, Seth. Thanks, Seth.